जाए। वन सहाबी रजी अल्लाह ताला अन्हु केम टू रसूलुल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड ही सेड या रसूलुल्लाह व्हेन आई वाज इन कुफर बिफोर इस्लाम आई यूज्ड टू गो ऑन जर्नीज सो वन डे आई आस्क्ड माय वाइफ टू मेक मी सम ब्रेड एंड दिस सो आई आस्क्ड हर टू मेक मी व्हाट वी वुड से अ जिंजर ब्रेड मैन मेक एवरीबॉडी अंडरस्टैंड सो ही सेड आई टुक माय राशन विद मी And I traveled for many days. So whatever food she had packed for me, my travel went for the weather or something, it lengthened. So by the time I reached to the other place, I had run out of food. So every morning I used to bring out this gingerbread man and I used to do puja to it. I used to worship it. Now I am hungry and I am seeing that he is my God also. And he is my gingerbread man also. And he is a biscuit. So he said, I said, Mahbub ji, please forgive me, I have to eat one hand today. So the second day he said, I ate the second hand. And he said, Maafi to him, Mahbub ji, please forgive me, I have to eat you now. Then slowly, slowly, he ate the whole, only the head was left. And then he ate the head. And this is, to us it seems like a joke. For that person, he ate his Mahbub, he ate his God. This is what they do. When they worship other things than Allah, ذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِنُورِهِمْ وَتَرَكَهُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ اللَّهِ يُبْصِرُونَ Our Ustad told us, I remember on the tafsir of this ayat, that the highest authority in India is the Supreme Court's Supreme Justice. The Supreme Justice generally, he's a Hindu. Sometimes, very rare, he's a Muslim. Very rare. There have been some Supreme Justices who are Muslim. But generally, he's a Hindu. And after he does all the faisla, the qaza, he rules, he goes to a mandir and he does puja to a cow. He does puja to Hanuman. So he said, this is what the ayat means. ذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِنُورِهِمْ وَتَرَكَهُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ اللَّهِ يُبْصِرُونَ That Allah takes away the noor of hidayat from them. Alhamdulillah, Allah has granted us the noor of hidayat. So we should do shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today is a day where they do shirk with Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Allah will ask on the day of judgment to Isa alayhi salam, Mark, that did you tell them to worship you? So he said, ma qultu lahum illa ma amartani bihi, ani abudu Allah rabbi wa rabbakum, wa kuntu alayhim shaheedan ma dumtu fihim. فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ Oh Allah, I did not tell them to worship thee, worship me. I told them to worship only you. So they say that Isa alayhi salam, na'udhu billah, is the son of Allah. Isa alayhi salam, Allah mentions in the Quran his own statement, إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ آتَانِيَ الْكِتَابِ وَجَعْلَنِي نَبِيًّا Allah has made me his servant. Oh Allah, you have made me his servant. And oh Allah, you have given me the kitab and you have given me the nubuwwah. You know, people don't think about this. Sometimes Muslims also fall in this trap. So they go to grave worshipping. They go to the mazarat. We can go and visit. Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Kalla sawfa ta'lamun, thumma kalla sawfa ta'lamun. We can go and visit the grave, make dua for them. But they go and visit the grave and they ask from them. There is no difference to the Christians, because the Christian Catholics, they say that we ask Lazarus, who asks Jesus, who asks Allah. Lazarus is the man that Isa alayhi salam brought back to life. Quran mentions it. Isa alayhi salam had certain mu'jizats which were not given to other anbiya. One was that he could bring a dead person back to life. So the person who was dead and he brought him back to life, his name was Lazarus in the Bible. So they pray to Lazarus, who in turn pray to Isa alayhi salam, who prays to Allah. There is no in between. We pray directly to Allah. There is no in between. So we don't go to the graves to pray from them. We go to the graves to make dua for them. That's the difference. So sometimes we forget that where we are, Allah says, مَا الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةٌ كَانَا يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامَ. This, some people say, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نَوْزُ بِاللَّهِ is not Bashar. He is Noor. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to eat like us. He used to visit the bathroom like us. Angels don't eat. Angels don't go to the bathroom. Only humans eat. Jinn eat. Jinn also go to the bathroom. That's why when you go to the bathroom, what's the dua? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. Because they live there. So we should be careful. Especially in the open, if you go to the bathroom, you should not do anything in holes. There could be a snake there, or there could be jinn there. Don't worry, inshallah, no jinn will harm you here. Some people are already afraid, we are praying outside, some jinn might come.